Hello, and welcome to another video in our series of Microsoft Office 365 technical support modules. In this video, I'll show you how to add your registered domain name to Office 365 for professionals and small businesses without disrupting service to your existing email and public-facing website. You may want to use your registered domain name, such as contoso.com, with your Office 365 email and instant messaging, but continue to host your public-facing website with your current hosting provider. In this video, I'll show you how to do this using GoDaddy as the DNS hosting provider. Because each DNS hosting provider is a little different, you may need to contact your provider for additional help. Before you add your domain name to Office 365, keep in mind the following. To add a domain name, you must have already registered a domain name and have the sign-in credentials needed for your domain name registrar. If you don't have a custom domain name, you can buy one from a domain name registrar. If you already have a domain name but you don't have the sign-in credentials at your domain name registrar, contact the person who registered the domain name. Refer to the following help article for more information. If you are currently using custom domains in Microsoft Business Productivity Online Standard Suite, or BPOS for short, you cannot add the same domains to Office 365. When you verify your domain ownership to Office 365, you add a domain name system record, or DNS record for short, at your DNS hosting provider and have to wait for the record to propagate through the DNS system. The process usually takes about 15 minutes, but can take up to 72 hours. Although you configure your domain to work with Office 365 services, you can't let your domain expire by not paying your domain name registrar. If you don't renew your domain registration, your Office 365 services won't work. For example, email won't be delivered and link online won't work. Your domain name registrar will notify you when your domain registration is about to expire. To add your domain to Office 365 but keep your website at its current hosting provider, you have to create a DNSA record in Office 365 that points to the IP address for your website. If you don't know your website's IP address, contact your current website's hosting provider and explain that you need the IP address for your website to create an A record to route customers there. Then add your domain name in Office 365. Let's add a domain to Office 365. Sign in to the Microsoft Office 365 portal as an administrator. Click Admin from the top of the page. Click Domains from the left navigation menu. Previously added domains, if any, can be managed from the Domains section of the Microsoft Office 365 portal. Click Add a Domain. Enter your domain name into the text box. Click Next. On the Verify Domain page, click the drop-down menu and select your DNS hosting provider, which might be your domain name registrar, to view instructions for verifying your domain. We're using GoDaddy for this demonstration. Choose between using text or mail exchange record, also known as TXT and MX records respectively, to verify your domain. The instructions displayed on the page will differ based on the option you choose. We recommend using the TXT record option. Right-click the TXT record information listed on the page and select Copy. Now we'll add the TXT record to the DNS manager at GoDaddy. Leave the Microsoft Office 365 portal browser window open and sign in to your GoDaddy account in another browser window. Click My Account from the global navigation menu. Click the domain name that you wish to add to Office 365. In the Domain Details page, click Launch under the DNS Manager section. Scroll down and then under the TXT section, click Quick Add. Enter the information noted from the Microsoft Office 365 portal into the fields. Right-click the TXT value field and click Paste. Click Save Sewn File. Click OK on the Confirm dialog box. DNS record changes may require from 15 minutes to 72 hours to propagate through the system, so you should wait at least 15 minutes before you go back to Office 365 to verify the domain. Leave the GoDaddy browser window open and toggle back to the Microsoft Office 365 portal browser window. At the bottom of the Verify Domain page, click Verify. After the domain is verified, still in the Add a Domain wizard, click Cancel. Don't continue with the steps to update the name server records. We'll do this later. At this point, your domain name has been added to Office 365, but we haven't transferred the DNS management from GoDaddy to Office 365. So email messages, website traffic, and other network traffic for the domain are still routed to the current hosting provider, GoDaddy. Before transferring our DNS management from GoDaddy to Office 365, we'll add user accounts and email addresses into the Microsoft Office 365 portal using the newly added domain name, and we'll set up the A-Record redirection for our website. Let's add a user and email address using the new domain name. Click Users from the left navigation menu. Click New. Click User. Enter the required information to create a new user. Select the newly added registered domain from the domain drop-down menu. Click Next. Assign the appropriate permission for the user. Select the user's location. Click Next. Select the appropriate license options. Click Next. Choose to send a notification email and click Create. After you click Create, you'll see a confirmation page showing the new user with your newly added domain. You should repeat this process for all users who are currently using the domain for email. This will ensure that emails for the current existing email addresses will have a mailbox to go to when name server record management for the registered domain name is transferred to Office 365. The email addresses you create should be exactly the same as they are in their current email system. Otherwise, mail won't be delivered for the email addresses that are not present in Office 365. The user's email address will begin working when you switch DNS management to Office 365 by updating the domain's name server records. We'll do that later. Now let's add an A record for your website. You can add A records and CNAME records through the DNS manager on the Microsoft Office 365 portal. The A record will ensure network traffic for your website is redirected from Office 365 to where your website is currently hosted, so people can still get to your site after you switch your name server records. Click Domains from the left navigation menu. Click the domain name. Click DNS Manager from the top of the page. Click New. Click A Address. Enter an @ symbol into the hostname or alias field. Enter the IP address for your website. Choose the time frame for Time to Live, or TTL for short. If you're not sure what to choose for TTL, set it to 1 hour. Click Save. The A record is added to the DNS Manager page. It is also a good idea to add a CNAME record to ensure the public is directed to your website when they use the www. Prefix for your registered domain name. Click New. Click CNAME. Enter www into the hostname or alias field. Enter the address for your website. Choose the time frame for Time to Live, or TTL for short. If you're not sure what to choose for TTL, set it to 1 hour. Click Save. The CNAME record is added to the DNS Manager page. It is now safe to update your name server records at GoDaddy to transfer DNS management to Office 365. On the Microsoft Office 365 portal, click Domains from the left navigation menu, click the domain name, click Troubleshoot Domain, click I have not changed the settings at my provider yet, click Next. In the Edit Name Server Records page, click the drop-down menu and select your domain name registrar to view instructions for editing the name server records. Copy or write down the name servers listed in the instructions. Toggle back to the GoDaddy browser window. Click Domain Manager from the top of the page. Click Name Servers. Click Set Name Servers. Click I have specific name servers to my domain. Type or paste the name server information noted from the Microsoft Office 365 portal into the Name Server 1 and Name Server 2 fields. Delete the information listed in the Name Server 3 and Name Server 4 fields, if any. Click OK. Toggle back to the Microsoft Office 365 portal browser window and click Next at the bottom of the page to complete the process of adding a domain to Office 365. After you have updated your name server records and the change has propagated through the DNS system, email will begin to be routed to Office 365, but traffic to your website address will continue to go to your current hosting provider. This completes the process of adding your registered domain to Office 365. Note that it may take up to 72 hours until the changes are fully propagated through the DNS system. Note that email may continue to go to the old email system until the changes are fully propagated. In this video, we looked at how to add your registered domain to Office 365 for professionals and small businesses without disrupting service to your existing emails and public-facing websites. Thanks for watching this video, and I hope that you found it helpful.